Okay, so, John, I thought you've learned your lesson, but apparently not, so here I am yet again. Now, some of you might know this, but John and I have a little bit of a history together. It usually goes like this. I write a blog post, John reads that blog post, disagrees for some reason, and then I get a comment like this. Jonathan, this is all very well thought out and wrong. And then paragraphs upon paragraphs, I had to cut the image here, explaining exactly why I'm wrong. Well, now I am in the funny position to say, John, this is all very well thought out and wrong. You simply lack the experience to see the bigger picture. First of all, it's not Westconst, it's Constwest. Obviously. But okay, you say using Eastconst leads to more consistency. Well, it doesn't, because the majority of people use Westconst. Oh, Constwest, sorry, used to that. So using Eastconst makes you actually inconsistent with the majority of code. But okay, that's what you call the foolish consistency, so I'm not going to dwell on that. These are the rules for const, and you correctly pointed out, if you always put const on the right, you can simplify that rule. Const modifies what's on its left, period. This is simpler, easier, more consistent. Can't argue with that. However, it's based on const pointers to const, which is a bold move to base such an important life decision on raw pointers in 2018. But okay, so this is a const pointer to const char, or you know, a const standard string view, but not the second const. This means this is not the full picture. This is the full picture. And when we have an initializer, we can use auto. Okay, maybe we have to help auto a little bit to get the extra const in there. And maybe some of you point out this, where we don't have an initializer, and I say congratulations on being the average C++ now attendee. But we don't actually need that either. We can just use a reference, because the pointer's probably in a null, otherwise just use null pointer. So by putting const always on the left, and when that's not possible, simplifying the declaration, we have this rule. Const modifies what's on its right, period. As simple, as consistent, but leads to a better code. Now, constbest people say, I want to read const and integer. Eastconst people say, you do, you just have to read from right to left. But I don't want to read from right to left. I read left to right. This is while I is less than 42. This is not 42 less than I while. And you can even read... and you can even read declarations from left to right without any problems. Constant, integer, pointer. Integer, array of size 3. Integer, returning function taking constant integer reference. That is const qualified. No problem there. Okay, what about this? You can't read that left to right because you can't read it. You have to follow the clockwise spiral rule, which is ridiculous. So people don't write it that way. They write this, which is completely equivalent. Maybe. Now, I could go on and on explaining why constwest is clearly superior and all Eastconst people are misguided, but I'm not going to do that. I could also organize cheap plastic bands and hand them out, but Peter already did that for me, so don't have to do that either. Instead, I'm going to do the mature thing and offer a compromise. A compromise solution that would make both sides really unhappy. I call it constwest Eastconst. And Clang even accepts it. So, thank you.
You want?